You're not going to want to miss this episode of the AI Show, where we talk about the Azure Machine Learning Designer, some of the new capabilities. It's pretty cool. Make sure you tune in. Hello and welcome to this episode of the AI Show. We're going to talk about something called the Azure Machine Learning Designer. I've got a special guest with me, Lou. How about you tell us who you are and what you do, my friend?
Hello, everyone. My name is Lou Zhang. I'm a program manager from Azure Machine Learning team.
So tell us a little bit about what the designer is for those that are maybe not familiar.
Sure. Yeah. Designer is basically the drag and drop visual interface that you can easily build, test, and deploy a production ready model with low code or no code.
So for those that know about it, what's new this time around?
Yes. So for designer this time, there will be a new layout. There will be a couple of new algorithms like image classification, like recommendation. And we also have improved the debugging and troubleshooting experience for you.
So I love knowing about stuff, but I'd love to see if you have something to show. Do you have something to show us?
Sure. Yeah, I can show that. Okay. What you see here is the homepage of Designer in the Machine Learning Studio. And as you can see from the homepage, there are a bunch of examples from the image classification to recommendation to linear regression. Also, you can even use custom Python script to build your own model. So what we are going to show today is how you can use the new sample image classification using the DenseNet to build a classification model. As you can see, this is the sample pipeline, and it starts from an image animal dataset, convert to the image directory with a bunch of transformation, and then you use DenseNet to train a PyTorch model. And after that, you should be able to score the model and evaluate that. So I'm going to submit a pipeline run on top of that. I can select a compute target. Please note, because it's using the DenseNet, so you will be using the GPU cluster. And then I will submit a pipeline run.
So as you're submitting this, just a couple of questions. Basically, the designer lets you create a flow for what I would call a machine learning pipeline. Is that right?
Yes. The backend is the machine learning pipeline.
I see. And so when this is actually running, it's basically going to run everything in parallel that it can and everything in series that it has to. Is that right also?
Yeah, the pipeline is basically the orchestrator that will decide when to run which node.
That's pretty cool. And how long does something like this take to train?
It depends on the data, the volume, and which skill you choose for the compute target. So for this example, because we choose the GPU, it's going to take a couple of minutes to finish run.
And then the other question is, what kinds of things, because it looks like you just went from the sample and it just drew out this huge thing, but if you start from a blank canvas, what kind of things can you drag on to that designer canvas?
Sure. Yeah. You can check the left side, the asset library. We have the data set, which is what you've already registered using the data set capability in Azure Machine Learning. We also have a bunch of modules available from data transformation processing to feature selection to machine learning algorithm. You will have basic regression clustering, and you will also have like for text analytics, computer vision, and the recommendation. So basically already a rich set of built-in modules you can drag and drop into the canvas.
So I'm guessing that, and maybe I'm wrong, but I'm guessing you already have one of these runs that is done already, so we don't have to watch it. Is that the case?
Yeah, yeah. So I will share the one which already has finished running. And in this example, actually, I'm using a real register data set. This comes from the labeling project, and we use that as the input to the pipeline. And we then use a custom module that converts it to the image directory to the format we want. And after that, there are a bunch of transformation, and ultimately you will finish running to get the result. And I can show the results, what you will see. For example, for this score image model, you can right click to visualize for each of the image what is the probability that you assign to each class. For this one, you are telling which one is bookstore versus warehouse versus subway picture, and the score label will tell you like what the actual model predicts.
So as I'm looking at this, let's just say you're happy with the model that's been built. Is there an easy way to deploy this?
Yes, definitely. So from the designer portal, you should be able to, after it run, finished running, you should be able to convert that into an inference pipeline. And that will automatically generate a real-time inference pipeline, something like this. And you see, we are now taking the web service input as the input to the trained model. And then you will get the prediction results returned from the REST API.
I see. So not only do you have the training pipeline represented in the training pipeline, but you also have the inference, because obviously when you're training versus when you're doing inference, it's kind of, it's a similar thing, but it's still different. And you can represent both in the designer. Is that right?
Yes. And this is all automatically generated. So you don't need to worry about how to build an inference pipeline from scratch.
Well, this is quite impressive. So what does it look like when you actually deploy the endpoint?
Sure, yeah. You can just click on the deploy button after you got the real-time inference pipeline. And then you can choose the Azure Kubernetes cluster to deploy it. That will take a few minutes to finish deployment. But once you finish that, you should be able to go to the endpoint page to check the actual deployment. And I'm going to show the one I have deployed before. And you will see the details of the real-time endpoint. The REST endpoint can be easily copy-paste. And what's more interesting is you can select image from your local computer to test what it means to score the model. And I'm going to do this, use the sample here, and you will see the actual prediction to verify your model. And once you want to go to the production, you will also get the sample code, how to consume that in your application using C#, Python, or R. That will be very handy for you to integrate into your application.
So this is all pretty amazing. I mean, it goes from not only the beginning of training, but all the way to at inference time and even testing. Where can people go to find out more about this?
They can find it from our documentation site, from the Azure Machine Learning official website. So all the resources will be available there.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for spending some time with us, Lou. And thank you so much for watching. We've been learning about some of the cool new features in the Azure Machine Learning Designer. Make sure you check it out. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time. Take care.